Very good morning to all of you students. Welcome to the physics class. In this session, we will discuss chapter number 1 of class 11th, and the name of the chapter is Physical World. Student, this is the first chapter, and in this chapter we will discuss only some laws of physics, some physical properties of physics, and relation of physics with other branches of science. Okay student, this is the basic chapter and this is the starting of your 11th class. Clear? So it starts. Now, first of all, we will discuss what is physics. So physics is a branch of science. The word physics has come from a Greek word meaning nature. The word science has come from a Latin word scientia, which means to know. So we can say that physics is the subject of studying nature and natural phenomena. It means that with the help of physics we can studying the natural phenomena and what is the nature of some physical subjects. Clear? Okay students, now we will discuss here the scientific methods. There are number of methods which can be used for the science, for the observation of any experiment, for the finding the relation of any other subject with the help of science. So these are the methods we will discuss here one by one. Student, first is the observation of facts. Second one is proposing theory or hypothesis to explain the observation. Next one is testing the validity of the theoretical predictions based on the proposed theory, and the next one is modification of the theory if necessary. So these are the scientific method. Clear? Okay students, now the next topic is branches of physics. As you know that physics is a broad subject and it contains a number of branches. So here we will discuss what are the branches of physics are take place. Clear? Okay students, so the first branch is mechanics, second one is waves and oscillations, next heat and thermodynamics, properties of matter including fluid mechanics. This is important branch of physics. Next one is electrodynamics, and next is optics and relativity, atomic physics, nuclear physics, electronics and communication, astrophysics, and next one is computer science. So these are the main branches of physics, and in these branches we will discuss the different parts of a science. Clear? Okay students, now nature of physical laws. As you know that we studying the number of laws which are related to physics, so in this topic we will discuss some important physical laws. First is the conservation of mechanical energy. Conservation means constant. So according to this conservation law of mechanical energy, means total energy of any system remains constant. Here total energy means kinetic energy plus potential energy, because we know that when a body moves in any surface, then it have potential energy due to its position and kinetic energy due to its motion. If the total energy is conserved for that system, then we can say that the energy of system is constant. Clear? Okay, next one is conservation of total energy of an isolated system. Student, according to this principle, the mechanical energy is conserved if the forces involving are conservative. If some of the forces during work are non-conservative, then the part of a mechanical energy is transferred into other form. Clear? So it means that we can say that the conservation of total energy of an isolated system is constant. Clear? Okay, now the next one is conservation of mass plus energy. स्टूडेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास प्लस एनर्जी टोटल मास प्लस एनर्जी ऑफ द यूनिवर्स इज कॉन्स्टेंट. दैट मीन्स द अमाउंट ऑफ मास इज कन्वर्टेड इंटू एनर्जी एंड द एनर्जी इज ऑल्सो कन्वर्टेड इंटू मास. सो देर इज अ रिलेशन डेल्टा ई इज इक्वल टू डेल्टा एम इंटू सी स्क्वायर. दिस इज अ वेरी नोन रिलेशन विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज आइंस्टाइन इक्वेशन ऑफ मास एनर्जी रिलेशन. क्लियर? सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रिलेशन वी कैन से दैट एनर्जी कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू मास एंड मास कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू एनर्जी. क्लियर? ओके. नाउ स्टूडेंट नेक्स्ट वन इज कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मोमेंटम. एज वी नो दैट एनर्जी इज अ स्केलर क्वान्टिटी. ऑल कंजर्व क्वान्टिटीज आर हाउ एवर नेसेसरी स्केलर्स. द टोटल लीनियर मोमेंटम एंड द टोटल एंगुलर मोमेंटम बोथ आर द वेक्टर क्वान्टिटीज ऑफ एन आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम आर ऑल्सो कंजर्व क्वान्टिटीज. दैट मीन्स दे आर कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर एनी सिस्टम इफ देर इज नो एक्सटर्नल फोर्स इज वर्किंग. क्लियर? सो दीज लॉज आर ड्राइव्ड फ्रॉम न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ मोशन इन द मैकेनिक्स. नेक्स्ट वन इज कंजर्वेशन ऑफ चार्जेस. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस द टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ चार्ज इन एन आइसोलेटेड सिस्टम रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट. इट मीन्स अ चार्ज कैन नीदर बी क्रिएटेड नॉर बी डिस्ट्रॉयड. क्लियर? नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज कंजर्वेशन ऑफ द नंबर ऑफ न्यूक्लियंस. दैट मीन्स मास नंबर. सो स्टूडेंट एज यू नो दैट इन ऑल द न्यूक्लियर रिएक्शन द नंबर ऑफ न्यूक्लियंस रिमेन्स कंजर्व. देर इज रीअरेंजमेंट ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स एंड न्यूट्रॉन्स इन डिफरेंट न्यूक्लियर रिएक्शन बट द टोटल नंबर ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स एंड प्रोटॉन्स इज सेपरेटली इक्वल फॉर द रिएक्शन एंड इट इज गिवन एज. सो वी विल कंसिडर हियर अ रेडियो एक्टिव डिके. सो हियर यूरेनियम इज कन्वर्टेड इंटू थोरियम एंड हीलियम इज इवॉल्व. सो फ्रॉम दिस रिएक्शन द टोटल नंबर ऑफ न्यूक्लियंस आर 238 इन बोथ साइड before and after the decay. It means that the conservation of number of nucleons take place in this reaction. Clear? Okay students, now fundamental forces in nature. Student, this is the important topic and in this topic we will discuss some fundamental forces which are working in our nature and what are the relation between them. So first is gravitational force. The force of attraction existing between any two separated bodies due to their masses are called gravitational forces. This is the definition of gravitational forces. These forces have following properties. First property, gravitational forces between bodies are always attractive. It means that they have the attractive nature. Now, they obey inverse square law, that is, they vary inversely as the square of the distance between the two bodies. They are the central forces, that is, they act along the line joining the center of the two bodies. Gravitational forces are long range forces and operate up to the very large distances. So these are the basic properties. These are the weakest forces in nature. Now the next one is weak forces. The weak forces were discovered during the study of beta emission from nuclei. During the beta emission, a neutron inside the nucleus is converted into a proton and electron and an antineutrino. So we can say that the weak forces are the forces which cause light elementary particles to interact with one another and with heavier particles. Clear? These are about 10 to power 26 times stronger than the gravitational forces. So this is the relation between weak forces and gravitational forces. Now next one is electromagnetic forces. These forces include electrostatic forces and magnetic forces. The forces between two stationary charges is electrostatic forces, while the force between two magnetic poles is called magnetic forces. Now the basic properties of electromagnetic forces are given as they have be attractive or repulsive like charges and Like poles repel each other, while unlike charges and unlike poles attract each other. They obey inverse square law. They are central forces and hence they are conservative. They operate up to the sufficiently large distances. Electromagnetic forces are about 10 to power 10 times stronger than weak forces and about 10 to power 36 times stronger than the gravitational forces. Clear? Okay. Next one is strong forces. These forces are the nuclear origin. They are responsible for holding neutrons and protons together inside atomic nucleus. They have following properties. The nuclear forces are basically attractive forces. They exist between neutron and neutron, between proton and proton, and between neutron and proton. They do not obey inverse square law. They are non-central and hence non-conservative. They are extremely strong range forces and act over distances of the order 10 to power minus 5, 15 meter, which is very small. Nuclear forces are the strongest forces found in nature. That means these are the strongest forces which is known in the nature. Now, the relation between all the forces, like gravitational forces, weak forces, electrostatic forces, and strong forces, is 1:10^26, 10^36, 10^39. Clear? Okay. Now, students, the next topic is applications of physics in technology and society. So first of all, we will discuss the application of physics in technology. So there are number of examples. The Newton's law of motion and find application in the flight of rockets, and Bernoulli's theorem in the designing of aeroplane wings. Second one is the particles of thermodynamics have been utilized in heat energies in refrigerators and air conditions. Next one is the electric bulbs, lamps and the tubes are based on conservation of electric energy into light. The electromagnetic induction discovered by Faraday has found application in the electric generator, motors, furnace, etc. Clear? At thermal power station, the chemical energy of burning coal is converted into electrical energy. The energy released in nuclear fission process is utilized in nuclear reaction, which produce electric power. Okay, students, now the next one is the properties and the theory of propagation of electromagnetic waves is applied in radio, television and wireless communication. An X-ray machine is used to identify internal diseases in the body. A geostationary satellites enable us to watch long distance TV program to forecast weather and to make geophysical surgery. So these are the basic uses in the technology. Clear? The calculation and the computers are based on digital electronics. Now students we will discuss in the society, means how can we use the application of science in the society. So in the case of society, see student, the development in the physics are having a direct impact on society. A number of examples can be given: telephones, telegraph, telex, teleprinter, and now fax are the more extensively examples of science which is used in the society. Radio, television, satellites are the means of the communications have connected all the parts of the science. Calculators, computers and lasers have changed day-to-day life of mankind. Clear? The development of nuclear power has become a threat to existence of life on the earth. So these are the applications in society. Now student, physics in relation to other science. As you know that physics is a branch of science, so it have a some relation between the other branches of science. So first, physics in relation to chemistry. So there is a big relation between physics and chemistry, like X-ray, diffraction, radio activity. These are the parts of chemistry as well as physics. Now, physics in relation to biological science. It is also related to the biological science, like find the X-ray, radioisotopes, finding the structure of body with the help of instruments. So these are the example of physics in relation to the biological science. Clear? Now, physics in relation to astronomy. The giant astronomical telescope of physics are used to check or find the shape of planets and other heavenly bodies for the solar system. So this is the example of physics in relation to astronomy. Physics in relation to mathematics. The theories in physics are based on various mathematical concepts. For example, electromagnetic theory is just a set of mathematical equations. Clear? So we can say that physics is also related to mathematics. Clear? Okay, student. Now, physics in relation to other science. So the laws and procedure used in physics have led to development of many new sciences like biophysics, geology, meteorology, and other subjects related to science. So student, in this chapter we will discuss only the nature of science and how can we correlate physics with other subjects, and what are the branches of physics, and what are the laws are important which is generally used in our daily life, and they all are the part of physics. Clear? So student, read this chapter and learn the basic concept of physics and their properties. Clear? Okay, student. Thank you very much.